Good morning, students. Today we are going to start a new lesson, that is nationalism in Europe. This lesson from history, first lesson, nationalism in Europe, is a very important lesson. In this lesson, first you can see a picture in the textbook. That means, see here. Here you can see a Statue of Liberty. That statue is known as Statue of Liberty. And in front of the Statue of Liberty, you can see a queue or a procession of different people carrying different color flag. Okay, that different color flags you can see that represent different nations. That flags are different nations and the people are of that particular nation. And you can see some people, they have passed, just passed the, in front of the, just passed away from the Statue of Liberty. That countries, if you analyze, in the corner you can see USA flag, you can see. See it very minutely, it you have to see. And USA, and behind that France you can see, and in front of this Statue of Liberty you can see Germany, and behind that many flags which represent Austria, Switzerland, Holland, Poland, England, like that many countries you can see. Why do these people are, what it represents, or what these people are, why they are moving in front of the Statue of Liberty? This is a painting, actually it is a painting done by Frederick Soriot in 1848, and the theme or the topic's name, that is known as World Made Up of Democratic and Social Republic. This is the name of the picture, World Made Up of Democratic and Social Republic. Okay, and in this you can see USA, which passed, just passed in front of the Statue of Liberty, means they have made, or USA have reached a level of nation state, or USA nation state process was finished. Behind that France also nation state formation just finished. In front of that Germany nation state formation is going on. Switzerland, Holland, Poland, they are far away, which means far away from Statue of Liberty, means they have not yet achieved the nation state process. Now we will see, what do you mean by nation state? Nation state means, you can see that people of a particular country or citizens, they share a common culture, common identity, that is known as, and share a common history, then it is known as nation state. So nation state means, suppose India is a nation, we have one flag, right, no? And we have one national anthem. This represents the nation state. That formation of nation state was on the way. So there was a you can see the Statue of Liberty, and the countries were in the process of nation state formation. Now we can see that this nation state process, which started from actually from France. So French Revolution you have learned, right? French Revolution, and this French Revolution marked the starting of the nation state. Okay, and the French Revolution, when it started in 1789, French Revolution, year of French Revolution, and French Revolution was the beginning. When French Revolution started, soon that spirit of nation state or the process of nation state spread in different other countries, neighboring countries like Belgium, then what we say, Switzerland, England, Poland, Russia, many such countries started the same spirit, or Italy, Germany, these old countries started the nation state formation. So about that nation state, how these countries have achieved nation state, that we have to study in this particular lesson. Okay, now I am going to discuss you about, last year you have learned about French Revolution, right? French Revolution you have learned about the right, equality of citizens. There were three estates, first estate, second and third estate, and you have studied so far how they fought for the equality before law, their freedom, etc., and the absolute monarch, from that freedom they have wanted to get. So how they got it from Louis XVI, that we have studied. Okay, we have to recollect now in this lesson for some time. So you can see that the French Revolution marked the clear expression of the nation state formation, and the French revolutionaries made many efforts to bring that nation state formation. What were those they had done, or French revolutionaries had done to attain that nation state? That is one of the important thing that we have to discuss. Means French revolutionaries, what they did to make a sense of belonging, sense of collective belonging, we can say, sense of collective belonging in the sense the same, which means nation state. So what they have done actually, sense of collective belongings, for that what they have done, first thing that the French revolutionaries, first they had a estates general, or estates general in the sense a meeting for the three estates, they had a meeting, right? That estates general, which became which was actually of active citizens, but which came to be known as later, because of the French revolutionaries, in order to create the nation state, they have made it National Assembly, means National Assembly was made. So National Assembly is the new name for the what we say, the estates general. Okay, second thing, that the hymns, or the for the country, hymns means some patriotic song, you can say. These were composed, hymns were composed for the nation. Then third thing that we can see, national anthem was made. Okay, national anthem, what they have done, means French revolutionaries done. Okay, and they also had martyrs, or martyrs means in the French Revolution, where martyrs were commemorated. Commemorated means what? They had given equal enough respect. So martyrs had been commemorated, means martyrs means those who had participated in the French Revolution, they became the martyr. So they were given due respect during this time, in order to represent the nation, that we all are doing this to make the country a nation. Okay, so this is one of the things that they had done. Next thing that they have done, that is centralized administrative system, they had brought, or they have brought a centralized administrative system. Okay, centralized administrative system was made, and these all they have done for the nation. So centralized administrative system they had done. Then uniform system of ways and measures, that also, way and measure means for weighing the commodities. Uniform system of ways and measures also they have introduced. These all they have done, and they have made a common currency. French became the national language for the nation. These all they have done for the nation. So this is known as, what are the important steps taken by the French revolutionaries to make a sense of collective belonging? So first thing we have learned, that National Assembly, three estates general, that was made into National Assembly. Second thing, hymns were made, then national anthem was created, then martyrs were commemorated, centralized administrative system was made, uniform system of ways and measures they had done, and the French national flag, that was tricolor flag, which was introduced. Then again they had accepted a common language for the entire nation, that was known as French. Okay, these all the sense of collective belonging that the French revolutionaries did. And by following this, these all other countries like Switzerland, Germany, Italy, everywhere this type of sense of collective belonging spread. From France to other countries, it spread. So this is one of the important things that you have to study today.